Hello and welcome to BYJU'S IAS, presenting to you the daily quiz for 3rd of October 2021. Let us begin and have a look at the first question for today. Consider the following statements with respect to Langa and Manganiar. They are folk artists famous for their folk dance called Kalbelia. They are Muslim communities predominantly residing in Ladakh. They play a traditional percussion instrument called Kartal. Which of the given statements is or are correct? Why this question? This article in the Hindu newspaper today talks about the steps that are being taken to digitize the unique musical performances of the Langas and the Manganiars. Who are they? Let us find out as we answer the question. The Langas and the Manganiars are folk artists, and to be very specific, they are folk musicians. They are famous for their music and not the Kalbelia dance, so statement number one becomes incorrect. These people are hereditary communities of Muslim musicians who mostly reside in the western Rajasthan's Jaisalmer or Barmer districts and also in Pakistan's Sindh. So statement number two also becomes incorrect. The major difference between Manganiars and the Langas is that they both serve different patrons. The Manganiars serve mainly Hindu patrons and the Langas serve the Muslims. But nowadays this trend is changing because both the communities perform for a vast audience. And please note that in their musical performance they play a traditional percussion instrument that is called as Kartal. Therefore statement number 3 is the only correct statement. So the right answer to our question would be option C, 3 only. Moving on to question number 2. In which of the following states can Gangetic river dolphins be found? Assam, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Jharkhand, West Bengal. Before we discuss the answer, let us know a little bit more about the Gangetic river dolphins. These Gangetic river dolphins are one of the oldest creatures in the world and they can only live in fresh water. Also remember that they catch their prey in a unique manner, that is by using ultrasonic sound waves. Why? Because they are essentially blind. And this Gangetic river dolphin is the national aquatic animal of India. They are distributed across 7 states in India, that is all these 5 states as well as Bihar and Madhya Pradesh. Therefore, the right answer to our question would be option D, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Here is a task for you for today. That is to find out the IUCN conservation status for Gangetic dolphins. And also there is a city in India that has declared the Gangetic river dolphin as its city animal. Let me know in the comment section which city I am talking about. We've taken this question because there is a reference to the Gangetic river dolphin in this article in the PIB today. Moving on to question number 3. Uronema africanum Borge recently in news is... Option A, an alga that can digest low-density plastic sheets. Option B, an oil-eating bacteria. Option C, a soil fungus which can use enzymes to rapidly break down the plastic materials. Option D, a bacterium that can aid the production of bioplastics. Why this question? This article in the Hindu newspaper today talks about Uronema africanum Borge. So what exactly is this? It is an alga identified by the researchers that can break down low-density polythene or plastic sheets. So this can act as an agent of biodegradation of plastics. So how is this discovery significant? We know that a ridiculously huge amount of plastic waste is generated each year. And in India, only 60% of the plastic waste that is collected is recycled. And this plastic pollution has serious environmental hazards. And the methods of disposal of plastic waste have some or the other limitations. And this biodegradation is something that the researchers are interested in because it is safe and also it is environment friendly. The studies prior to this had found out many other organisms that can also help in biodegradation of plastics. For example, there was Idonella saccharensis, which is a bacterium species that is capable of breaking down plastic. And then there was a soil fungus which was also discovered, which used its enzymes to rapidly break down plastic materials, and this was called Aspergillus tubingensis. And also the larvae of wax moth Galeria melonella had shown to degrade polyethylene into ethylene glycol. And now recently in news is Uronema africanum Borge. And this is a microalgae that is found in Asia, Africa and Europe. And this has shown the potential to degrade low density plastic sheets. Therefore, the right answer to our question would be option A, an alga that can digest low density plastic sheets. Moving on to question number 4. Which of the given statements is or are incorrect with respect to the Indian Astronomical Observatory located in Hanle in Ladakh? It has one of the world's highest located sites for optical, infrared and gamma ray telescopes. It houses Asia's largest fully steerable optical telescope. Night observations at Indian Astronomical Observatory Hanle from 2M Himalayan Chandra Telescope are possible throughout the year without any interruption due to monsoon. What is the context? This article in the Hindu newspaper today talks about the Indian Astronomical Observatory that is located in Hanle in Ladakh. A recent conducted study has said that this site is becoming one of the most promising observatory sites globally. Why? Because it is geographically situated at such a location where there are more clearer nights, minimal light pollution, background aerosol concentration, and extremely dry atmospheric conditions. And these conditions facilitate uninterrupted research activities. Now let us go back to the question. Statement number 1 is correct because it has one of the world's highest located sites for optical, infrared as well as gamma ray telescopes. Coming to statement number 2, Asia's largest fully steerable optical telescope is not located in Hanle in Ladakh. It is located in Devasthal in Uttarakhand. So statement number 2 becomes incorrect. And statement number 3 is absolutely correct, and this is why it is among the most promising observatories in the world. So the right answer to our question would be option B, 2 only, because the question is asking us for the incorrect statement. Now let us take up a previous year question from Prelims paper 2018. Which one of the following best describes the term merchant discount rate sometimes seen in the news? Option A, the incentive given by a bank to a merchant for accepting payments through debit cards pertaining to that bank. The amount paid back by the banks to their customers when they use debit cards for financial transactions for purchasing goods or services. Option C, the charge to a merchant by a bank for accepting payments from his customers through the bank's debit cards. Option D, the incentive given by the government to merchants for promoting digital payments by their customers through point-of-sales machines and debit cards. What is this merchant discount rate? The merchant discount is the rate that is charged to a merchant who uses point-of-sale device for processing the payment services. This fee, that is the merchant discount rate, is charged by the banks on credit and debit card payments that is accepted from the consumers for any service or goods that are bought. So the right answer to our question would be option C. The fact of the day for today is toxic firecrackers. What is the context? Very recently, Supreme Court observed that 6 major firecracker manufacturers had violated its orders that it had issued, asking them not to use prohibited chemicals and toxic ingredients like barium salts in firecrackers. Also, earlier, the Supreme Court had ordered these manufacturers to label their firecrackers in compliance with the law. But unfortunately, even this is not being followed by many. So the court is trying to ensure that the right to clean air under Article 21 of the Constitution is given to its citizens. To understand the controversy, we must first understand how firecrackers work. See, the firecrackers use fuel and oxidizers to produce a combustion reaction. And as a result, the explosion that takes place spreads the material in a superheated state. The metal salts that are added in the firecrackers in the explosive mix get excited and the light is emitted. And the different metals added in this mix produce different wavelengths of lights in this reaction. For example, strontium and lithium salts produce red light and barium salts produce green light. This gives us a spectacular view, but it is a peak source of pollution. Agreed? It increases the level of elements in the air. For example, it increases the level of strontium, magnesium, barium, potassium, as well as copper. And this aggravates the already poor ambient air quality in Indian cities. The ingredients such as strontium can replace calcium in the body, and this is very toxic. And some compounds can also hamper the growth in children. And that is why this is of serious concern. And this is the reason why there was a litigation that was calling for a total ban on firecrackers. There have also been instances of many firecrackers that violate the legal limits on sound. That is why in the year 2018, the Supreme Court gave out an order for a full ban on firecrackers. It issued orders stating that only a reduced emission and green crackers would be allowed. But there would also be tight restrictions on the timings when they could be burst. So what is this alternative and can these green crackers make a difference? See, in this green crackers, components in firecrackers are replaced with other components that are less dangerous and less harmful to the atmosphere. And the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, through its National Environmental Engineering Research Institute in Nagpur, has come out with firecrackers that have reduced emission light and sound and 30% less particulate matter using potassium nitrate as an oxidant. And these green crackers are named as safe water releaser. And these green crackers by CSIR can be identified using unique QR codes to guide the customers. So introducing these QR codes is a new and unique feature for firecrackers. And this is done to avoid the manufacture as well as sale of fake products. And it is believed that these green crackers, while causing lesser damage to the environment, will also protect the livelihoods of millions of people that are engaged in the manufacture and sale of fireworks across India. That is all for today. Thank you for being with us. Keep watching and keep learning.